Welcome to Cedar City, Utah, on the campus of Southern Utah University for the MRGC dual meet opener for Southern Utah and Utah State in their 112th all-time meeting on the gymnastics floor. Hi, everybody. Welcome inside the AFEX. Spencer McLaughlin, Kimmy Hermanson joining me here on ESPN+. And these are two programs that are early in their season. Southern Utah, their fourth meet of the year. Utah State, their second. But both these programs know how to compete in college gymnastics at a high level.
Absolutely. They've had all the training. I know that we're really excited for SU to have a home meet. They've been on the road a lot, I've been told, so this will be exciting to see how it opens up.
Southern Utah opened this year in Las Vegas with a win in their section at the Las Vegas Super 16 against the likes of Washington and North Carolina. They followed that up with their best ever showing a week ago at the Best of Utah with a 196.175. They also tossed in a win here at home against New Hampshire in a non-conference dual meet, but now they go up against a Utah State team that has a new head coach but still has a lot of really, really talented gymnasts because they're a really high-level program.
She's done a great job just being a new coach, a new head coach. It's always hard to take on a new program, so it's really impressive to see them come out of the gate, especially with their first meet being Best of Utah last week. And what did you say, 195? I mean, that's a great score opener for the season. So that says a lot about her and what she's doing with the program and the culture she's creating there.
Kristen White is Utah State's new head coach. We'll talk about her a bit later. But 95.8 to open the season for Utah State. Now they jump right into conference play, and it's their second highest opening season score in program history. Not a bad way for a first-year head coach to make a good impression.
Exactly. You said it. That's exactly right. It's exciting to see SUU as well with their 196. That's a huge score for them, and that was a big win, I think, for them as well.
Absolutely. Southern Utah has improved their score in each of their three meets so far this season. We'll step aside for a couple minutes, come back, and talk about each of these head coaches who are at different stages in their careers with their programs. Back after this. Well, these two programs, Southern Utah and Utah State, have been intertwined for quite some time on the gymnastics front. Nowhere is that more true than in the head coaching space. Head coach Scotty Bauman for Southern Utah enters year number 32, the longest tenured coach at Southern Utah University by a long shot, over three decades at the helm, and he has built this program into a national brand in college gymnastics and has done a mighty impressive job on that front. When he took this program over long, long ago, Kimmy, they were scoring in the 180s all the time, and it has just been a slow, methodical build. But now they're at the point where they come into tonight's meet ranked 21st in the country.
I think one of my favorite things about Scotty is his staff and the way they work together. And I think there's hardly any that can compare. Just the seamless interactions between all three of them with Jamie and Jeff. I mean, Scott and Jeff have been friends for lifelong friends. And you can see that out there. There's complete trust, respect. And I think that has such a huge part in building the program to what it is today. It's just an incredible dynamic team that they've created.
And they put out top-tier gymnasts year in and year out. One of them who you will have the privilege of seeing tonight, Carly McLean, is having an excellent start to her fifth year competing for Southern Utah on the gymnastics front. But is Steph, Jeff Richards, Jamie Weisong as well. They have formulated a true family-like atmosphere here in Cedar City. And that's what Utah State head coach Kristen White is now attempting to build in her own right. It's year one. You take over for a five-year head coach in Amy Smith, who had a wildly successful run herself. And now she's trying to get things going in that same sort of direction.
Exactly. It's really hard to, especially because I believe Amy took some of those girls with her to the new program that opened at Clemson. To be able to come here as a new coach and start off as strong as they did to create a program like this, it just speaks volumes about what she's trying to do for the program and where she came from as well.
And the other interesting link between these two programs, not just that they are conference foes along with BYU and Boise State, but Scotty Bauman got his starting coach at Utah State long ago under legendary Utah State gymnastics coach Ray Korn, who passed away in the last couple of years. But Scotty Bauman speaks very highly of him, as he should. And we are getting set to begin the rotations here tonight. Southern Utah's vault lineup this evening: Haley Voltaggio, Ellie Cachola, Carly McLean, Caitlin Coe, Kayla Pardue, and Rachel Smith. Judges are getting set to get things rolling, and we are getting set for our first vault in Southern Utah, unveiling their new leotards here tonight. And Haley Voltaggio is first up to get MRGC competition beginning for the Thunderbirds and the Aggies.
A great start on that Yurchenko fall. And that starts not at a 10-0 start value, so a 9.95, I believe. And even with that slight hop, it was a really clean vault. We're looking at trying to keep those shapes nice and flat as they're on their way down, not piking in those hips when she's landing. And we're looking for chest up. So she had a really clean vault. It was a good start for SEU.
Every coach loves to get off to a strong start. And when you put a performer at the beginning of the lineup, that's exactly what you're hoping she will do, is set the tone for the other five girls who will follow. And now Coach White turns to one of her six seniors on the roster from Monterey, New Mexico. Jessica Gutierrez notched a career best 9.825 last week at the Best of Utah.
A tough start right there, missing that first toe hand, probably into a release move. It's always hard as the first one puts the pressure on for the rest, but you have a certain amount of time to chalk up, get back up on the bar and reset. Minimize any deduction if you've made an error. Beautiful Maloney right into shoot to handstand, looking, hitting that nice handstand. Now, bars, the most important thing is making sure those lines are clean, handstands are hit, and dismounts are stuck just like that one. What a great finish after kind of a unfortunate start. Always something she's probably practiced a million times, and sometimes that just happens.
The sophomore from Owosso, Oklahoma, up next for Southern Utah, Ellie Cachola.
Great Yurchenko fall. The height coming off of that table was just incredible. You're looking for height and distance in vault. You can see right there, she just lifts and spots the landing, that slight hop, that was perfect.
There you can see assistant coach Robert Ladanyi talking things over with Avery Bibby, the true freshman from Chandler, Arizona.
Now, when they have six people in lineup, they count the five scorers, right? And it's always hard to have that first one start off with a fall. It puts a lot of pressure on the rest of those. So I think those words are always important from a coach when you're feeling that pressure getting ready to go.
Haley Voltaggio notches a 9.725. The first score has trickled in. That for Southern Utah on the vault. And now the impressive freshman Avery Bibby, who in her first career college gymnastics outing, how about this, Kimmy, a 9.825 at the Best of Utah, competing against the likes of Southern Utah, the Utes, a top five program in the country, BYU as well, not fazed by the pressure putting up a score like that.
Exactly, you said it best.
Another excellent crowd on hand here at the AFEC. They're continuing to fill it in. That's one thing that Scotty Bauman has preached year in and year out, the importance of community and alumni involvement to come and support his teams.
Oh, no. Slight error there. Huge Tkachev. And going into her next connection, she just shot out a little bit early on that clear hip and came down. It's always smart to come down, take a breath, collect, chalk back up, finish strong.
And you have to remember, for Southern Utah, this is their fourth time competing
exactly
here in the month of January since the season began. For Utah State, it's just their second. They opened last week at the Best of Utah, placing third with a 195.8, but they're still more than Southern Utah trying to work out those early season jitters.
Exactly. That's very well said. Exactly right. Something about competing, not in your home gym, with your own crowd. There you go, right to handstand. Beautiful transition right there to shoot to handstand. Again, hitting those handstands and doing it right. I love that they're finishing so strong. It says something about their consistency and trying. When they make an error, getting up and finishing up, it's really easy, I think, to let those things get in your head. But experienced athletes like this know how to get up, finish a routine. That was a great stick.
Carly McLean has been a rock star during her career here in Cedar City, and here she goes on her vault.
Wow. You can tell the crowd liked that one. Beautiful, your chinko full. You can see right here, strong run going into that vault. Gets those hands back and lifts right off the table. So she stays pretty flat all the way down, just has that slight hop at the end. Beautiful vault.
She has a 9.85 in front of her from Ellie Cachola. So Southern Utah off to a strong start. Utah State looking for some momentum here on the uneven parallel bars. They will have to count a fall in this score. But there you see the scores that have been reported into this point, and we will continue to keep you informed as they come in. This is Brianna Brooks, the junior, from just 2.5 hours down I-15 from here in Las Vegas. Utah State a year ago reached an NCAA regional under then fifth-year head coach Amy Smith, and Brooks put up a career high on bars at a 9.9 in that NCAA regional.
That was a beautiful transition. That first skill is called a ray. It's worth E value, connected right into a shoot. And double A to a stick, what a bar routine.
And that fires up her teammates and her coaches as well. And if you're Utah State, having two falls in your first two routines of the night, you're just trying to focus on what comes next and just continue to build the best score that you can as Kayla Pardue gets ready for her vault. Another talented freshman out there.
Wow, great. 1.5, Luchenko, that starts at a 10-0 value. 10-0 start value. So powerful. Such a strong run. She gets right into this table so quick and lifts right off the table. This is a 10-0 start value. It's a blind landing, meaning they cannot see the ground before they land. They have to have that air awareness to know where they are. With that slight step, it was a great vault. It's a hard one to stick.
Alexi Aragon, the senior from Salt Lake City, is up next. And I'm sure got more than a few looks from the tremendous slew of gymnastics programs that exist here in the state of Utah.
Exactly. Oh. Oh, no. Hard go for Utah State right now. It's hard to keep gaining momentum, especially when these are routines. You know, they practice day in and day out. They're throwing these release moves. They're no stranger to hitting consistently. There's more frustration, I think, on the inside of, oh, I know how to do this. And, you know, whether it's the pressure, whether just the timing off, or whatever it is, it's hard to kind of come out of that hole if you start going down it. Let's see how she finishes up. Hitting beautiful handstand, going into another Takachev. Great catch. Again, beautiful handstands. You can tell that this is all about, they're very clean. They've got good lines. Just kind of getting out some of those jitters, like you said, that preseason or early season jitters. Straight arms on the giant, just beautiful shapes. Full twisting double tuck dismount. Also an E dismount, just valued the same as a double A. You don't see those as often, but they are just as difficult.
Rachel Smith is up next, another senior. There's a large array of under and upperclassmen for Scotty Bauman on this roster. Smith, one of the veterans.
I love this vault. Such a unique vault. You don't see it very often. She halves on onto the table and pikes off with that twist. She does it well. Normally, I think she's done tuck in the past. I don't know that I've ever seen her perform the pike. You see, she does half twist on. It's more like three quarter and then off, and it is just very well done. She executes that vault well, and it's so fun to see things a little bit differently, you know, pull out some different skills.
So Southern Utah in this first rotation with three scores above a 9-8, a pair of 9-8-5s from Ellie Cachola and Kayla Pardue. Carly McLean, a 9-8-2-5. We'll see what Rachel Smith garners as the scores continue to roll in.
It's a strong start for Southern Utah in vault.
And they have been a very strong team here at home. They haven't lost since 2021. It's been almost 2 years since the team has bested them here on their home floor. Brianna Brooks
Beautiful.
Leading the way for Utah State on bars so far with a 9-8-7-5.
Ooh, that was close. That was nice. Maloney, toe hand, Maloney into pack, salto. You'll see that flip in between the bars. And again, just a little bit shy. You're trying to get those handstands within 10 degrees, even that blind pull. Very nice stick into the double. You're trying to look for, what judges are looking for is making sure those handstands are passing within, hitting within 10 degrees. So if you're always in handstand, there's just no second guessing, you're going to hit it. That's really what they're looking for. When you finish a blind change like that, if it's beyond the 10, that's what someone deductions come into play. That was a nice routine and a good comeback after having a fall.
That was Danny Kirstein for Utah State. That is Anna Hartley for Southern Utah.
You'll see on this one, she does have a little bit of a form break. She gets back nice, but ends up piking down right there. You're trying to get those hips all the way flat for that landing. It was a nice, strong finish for SU on vault.
The sophomore from McKinney, Texas, Amari Evans, rounds out this first rotation for Utah State. They would love a strong score to close it out and head into the vault, where Southern Utah is off to a really good start, over 49, pending the score from Anna Hartley, but Rachel Smith, a 9-7-7-5.
Again, so good on these handstands. Really clean. It looks like we're going right into a Maloney. Good backswing right into pack. Looking clean so far. Now they can only stand on low bar one time in a routine. Right into blindfold double tuck. Wow, great stick for them. And a strong finish after some of those mistakes that they made. That's got to be a lot of pressure on their anchor for bars, and she did a great job.
And the landings were excellent for Utah State on the bars. They will switch sides of the floor. Southern Utah will come over to the bars. Utah State to the vaults when we come back for rotation number two. You're watching College Gymnastics on ESPN Plus. An MRGC battle between two top 30 programs in the country coming into tonight. As we welcome you back inside the AFEX, Spencer McLaughlin, Kimmy Hermanson alongside me. Southern Utah over 49 in that first rotation. Seems like they are really starting to hit their stride this season in their fourth meet.
That was a great start for vault. They all looked really great. I'm anxious to see what bars bring.
For Utah State, meanwhile, a couple of falls in that opening rotation. They scored over 49 at the best of Utah, 49.025 on the bars, but now they have to respond and just focus on the next routine to try to put up a strong score.
I think it could be a lot as well to have away meets back to back. Not being in your home crowd and your own gym, your own equipment, that kind of thing. I'm not quite sure how they're going to do moving forward, but I think they have the experience to be able to pull together, rally for this next event. You know, you can see it in there and their bars. They have clean lines. Their skills look good. It's just a matter of putting all of that together like we talked about. And then we'll see how they come together on vault. It's always hard to get the morale back up when you kind of had some errors like that. But I think, like I said, they've got the experience to pull together and see how this next event turns out.
Utah State, unfortunately, had three gymnasts fall off of the apparatus in that first rotation. And there's a touch period ongoing right now, a few minutes, not just for the gymnasts to get warm, Kimmy, but also for the coaches to try to get their athletes to reset their minds.
Exactly. Just kind of that, okay, I know what I'm doing. I'm going to warm up, touch the equipment. We always talk about what warm-up actually is, that it's not an indication of what you're going to do in practice or what you're going to do in competition, but practice is the indicator, right? How you practice is how you compete. So a lot of times when my own athletes get nervous, it's that reminder of, you know, warm-up is not the indication of competition. It's there to feel the equipment. You can get your mind in the right space and then get ready to go. Do what you know how to do. Do know what you know how to practice. So we'll see how this event takes place for them. I think I'm hopeful that they'll pull this together and have a strong second event after some of those errors. And it looks like for some of them, it's going really well so far.
Well, for Southern Utah, they matched their best vault score of the season with a 49.025, highlighted by a career mark by Ellie Cachola with a 9.85. Haley Voltaggio started things off with a 9.725. That score ends up counting after Anna Hartley with a 9.7 there to close it off. But Cachola, number two, really set the tone for the gymnasts who followed her.
It's always great when you're just seeing those scores build, and I think that has a lot to do with how the coaches strategically place those girls in lineup. You know, do you want your strongest kid or your most consistent kid to start first? You have a good score and that sets the tone for the rest of the meet or for the rest of the event? Or is it, you know, you put your anchors, your most consistent, your strongest? Everybody kind of has their own strategy as far as how they place those lineups. And so this is going to be interesting to see how they go. It was a great start for vault to see those scores continue to build. And I'm anxious to see how bars comes together for them. They did really well at Best of Utah this last weekend. I mean, some huge scores, really clean, hit handstands. So let's see if we can see that today.
They notched a 49.15 a week ago up in Salt Lake City. Southern Utah took second, their best ever finish at the Best of Utah, featuring BYU and the Utes, in addition to the two programs that you're watching here tonight. And on the other side, for Coach Bauman and the Flippin' Birds, as they are referred to colloquially here in Cedar City, Kimmy, it's the opposite of Utah State. They're trying to not get overconfident after having a big lead after rotation number one, 49.025 to 47.825. It's about having a similar mindset, frankly, and just working on whatever the next routine is.
Exactly. You said that perfectly. It is about just keeping your mind in the right space, not getting overconfident, but just doing what you do every day. That consistency is key, especially when it comes down to competing. And it is great to be in your own gym, your own atmosphere with your crowd that's cheering you on. That can a lot of times just even build it that much more. So hopefully this momentum keeps them in a good mindset, and they can keep consistent like they were last week. Last weekend was incredible for an away meet. And I think they're ready to bring it for this event today.
And certainly no shame for Southern Utah taking second place to the Utes of Utah, one of the five best gymnastics programs in the country. Well, the judges have been told to get set, and it will be Angel Stewart, a 9.7 last week at the Best of Utah, in just the third vault of her career. She gets set for career vault number four here in Cedar.
Now, as I was watching their touch warm-up, what we just talked about, we had a couple of crunched ankles, some short landings there. You know, this is going to determine how they perform after this as far as staying in that mental game. Am I going to let my touch warm-up affect how I compete, or am I going to do what I know how to do, what I've trained to do, and get out there and hit my vault like I've been practicing? Full twisting Yurchenko. A great start for them. Quite a big hop at the end of that vault, but she's a quick twister. You could see her just get off that table pretty quick. A little bit slower. She pulls those toes right here fast, so she wasn't quite able to get the height, and she's had to pike down. That resulted in that hop backwards, but she was fast to make that twist around, so it's a good start for them after touch warm-up.
Caitlin, the one they call Cash Money Co., up now on the bars for Southern Utah.
Beautiful. Maloney straight into pack. I love that her ankles are together on those two releases, something that's easily done, like separation, just to get momentum. But she's nice and clean. Nice toe hand, and I think she goes right into full twisting double back, a hard connection bonus. Most of the time they use those giants in between to gain momentum so they can have a big dismount. To be able to just go straight from a toe hand right into a dismount says a lot about that difficulty. A few steps on that landing, but she seemed to pull that around and save it. She had very minimal deductions in that entire routine.
There's a look at the sophomore from Ankeny, Iowa, Peyton Gatzlaff, up next for Coach White and Utah State.
Very nice. Nice clean Yurchenko there. A little bit of pike down at the end, and then that resulting in that same hop we saw her first teammate do. You can see her get into the table just a little bit high on, and then has to kind of break that form right there at the bottom, resulting in the hop.
And so is the solution to that from a technical coaching standpoint to try to hit the platform a little bit sooner?
Yeah, exactly. So you're trying to get those hands back into the table with your toes slightly, like you don't want to be at past handstand or past vertical. That ends up kind of dumping the vault over. So being able to get into the table quick results in that amplitude off the table and the distance as well with their momentum taking them forward. So in order to keep that, you want those that form straight. You want to make sure you can get in quick.
Angel Stewart with a 9.65 first score that's come in for Utah State here in the second rotation as Aubrey Schwartz unfortunately unable to stay on the uneven bars.
She has a nice combo. She does handstand hop and then falls right into a Jaeger. But just a little bit too far away, and as a result couldn't quite hang on to it. They get one swing before they can start that kip. Any more than that would result in deduction. What a beautiful line. You can tell that was surprising for her to fall. Seems like she hits that very consistently. Blindfold double and a slight hop on the end, but a good strong finish after a fall.
Schwartz, who does not compete in the all-around, but regularly competes in three separate events. One of the most versatile gymnasts that Coach Bauman has got. Olivia Ostendorf is up next. 9.775 on her vault a week ago.
Oh, very nice. Quick to get into the table and a nice strong lift. Just a slight hop, which is great. There she goes, getting back into that table. And she's able to get up a little bit more. You can see a little bit of those line breaks. But, you know, the judges don't get a replay like we do, so they just got to go right off what they see. Just makes the sport tricky.
Maybe we should help them out. Just shout things down to them.
Oh, that's a good idea.
It's like, hey, did you catch this?
You missed this. I think you missed this. I actually did see that a little bit last weekend. There were some scores that were given away, and I thought, okay, well, if this was instant replay, I think you may have misjudged that. But you know what? I'm not a judge, so who am I to say?
Well, fans of other sports might point out that just because replay is there doesn't mean that they're necessarily going to see it the same way that you see it.
That is such a good point.
Caitlin Coe opened on bars with a 9.625. Aubrey Schwartz fell, and so Mason Bentley will look to get things really rocking and rolling for a Southern Utah team that is 18th in the country to this point in the season in terms of their team average on the uneven parallel bars.
Mason Bentley, St. George native from the same gym I work at. So fun to watch her compete. Huge ray right into shoot. A little shy on that handstand. Remember, we're looking for that straight up and down. Beautiful double lay. Great finish for Mason, especially coming back. It's always hard, like we talked about, that pressure of making sure you can hit your routine and do what you know how to do, especially when you have a teammate before you that falls. So different from club, where club is such an individual sport. College is all about team, every score that counts, and you're relying on your teammates. Just a different kind of atmosphere. I think those freshmen have a hard time adjusting to that when they come in.
This is the vault of Brianna Brooks.
Very nice Yurchenko fall. I did see a few falls, like I said, in warm-up, and so far they've all been able to come together, which I think is great. Their mind's in the right place, and they're gaining momentum. It's really great to see.
Brooks has the highest individual score in either rotation for the Aggies to this point. Her 9.85 on the bars from earlier, standing out, or 9.875, rather.
I just saw Carly tell herself, I got it. I love watching them talk to themselves, kind of go through their mental prep of what they need to hit the routine. Carly's such a strong all-arounder, and to do this 5 years in a row, I just couldn't imagine. You know, this is stuff she's been doing for longer, if you think about it, right? Being a level 10, which is essentially collegiate level, you know, you have to be that before you get to college. So I'm sure she's been doing these routines and skills for a long time. Beautiful clear hip to handstand right into a ginger. Again, hitting handstand and going right to shoot. Very solid shapes and lines. You can see the momentum building on that double A. Great finish for Carly McLean.
She had an NQS on the bars a year ago of 9.82. And the crowd chanting for a 10, as they often do for
yes.
the fifth year standout.
I know, because, you know, they don't see all the little things.
The details matter not to the student section.
Exactly.
They are here for one thing and one thing only, and that is a perfect 10.
It was a very close call on that routine, just a slight hop on the dismount. But she was very clean. She looked great.
This is Amari Evans for the Aggies.
Just a little short on that landing. You see she does a half on. It's more like three quarter on, quarter off. Let's see if we see that in the replay here. Three quarter. What's that, full actually? And then a pike off. So a little bit low on the landing. It's hard to get in so fast enough to get the amplitude off the table. But she had a good, she pulled that around.
Well, the strategy of how to deploy lineups always in play for coaches. And Shimer Akami in the fifth slot here on the second rotation holds the Southern Utah school record, her career best, a 9.975. And that came against Utah State a year ago.
A beautiful bar routine. I mean, her lines are stunning. She hits almost every handstand. She goes into that Higgins. Look at that handstand. I mean, the line there is just incredible. And then into her dismount. We call that the college stick, you know, that like stick and then hurry and salute. Yes, I would have to agree with the student section there. That was a beautiful routine.
Jenna
nice
Eagles rounds things out for Utah State here in rotation number two. Did not vault last week, but here she goes to start her 2023 campaign.
All right. A pretty strong finish for Utah State. Yurchenko full. You can see that speed getting into the table right here. Looking at open shoulder, she has a little bit of a shoulder closed on the angle and then a little bit of form break on those legs. Pulls that around with that slight hop. Again, we're always looking for that stick. We want to see that stick. Height and distance off the table are the big things they look for on a vault.
And to wrap out our second rotation, Bella Neff up for Southern Utah. Matched a 9.8 last week at the Best of Utah. And those are the scores that these Southern Utah coaches are striving for in every rotation. 9.8 and above.
Beautiful extension on that Maloney. Right into shoot, a little bit over. She held on to it though, looks really good. And again, hitting those handstands, that's so critical. Going blindfold just a little bit late. Double tuck, dismount. And their team's happy about it. That's a great way to finish.
High tens all around. We'll keep you updated on the scores. Utah State at a 48.425 in the second rotation with more still to come. And they just put up Shai Murakami's 9.925. We'll tell you where that
score
leaves Southern Utah right after this. Welcome back inside the America First Event Center. Spencer McLaughlin Kimmy Hermanson alongside me. Two rotations in the book, still two to go, but let's take a look at some of the best routines we saw there in that second rotation. Southern Utah had a couple of exceptionally strong ones, led by Shai Murakami's 9.925, the highest individual score we have seen so far tonight.
It was an incredible bar routine. She has such clean lines. It was a well-deserved score. Now that crowd wanted to see a 10. See that replay right here. You can tell she's such a seasoned athlete. That going right into a Higgins, right into her release. So clean, so confident. Again, just hitting that handstand and holding, just something everybody wants to see. Beautiful dismount. I mean, it was such a great routine. Well-deserved score for them.
And she followed a strong bar routine from Carly McLean, who likely to compete in the all-around for the fourth time in four meets this year for Southern Utah, has notched over a 9.8 in each of the first two rotations, and she looked very strong in her bar routine.
She did. I can't imagine going 4 for 4. That's four events every time, four meets. I think at one point they had three meets in a week. Is that right? It was like
just
Friday,
about
a Monday. I mean, that's so much competition. More than we realize, I think, on the mental and the physical. You can see right here into this bar routine, she knows exactly what she's doing. Hits those handstands, that shoot to handstand or bail. And then again, right, going into this dismount. Great double layout. Chest lands straight up. That's what they're looking for. They're looking for height, keeping their feet planted and their chest up. You know, it's one thing to stick a landing if your chest drops below. Those are deductions. And she just lands with such confidence at chest up. I mean, it was a great score. Great routine.
On the other side for Utah State, they upped their score from their first rotation of 48.550. Still, it's a team certainly with as much talent and experience as they have, capable of more, but progressing in the right direction in the context of this meet. And the best vault they had came from Olivia Ostendorf.
Right. With the rocky start they had, it was great to see them come back on vault. Right here, you can see this. A strong vault from her. She gets in really nice. Just has that slide hop at the end, but has good amplitude. This is a great vault.
So for Southern Utah, they continue to be a very, very strong home team. Second time they've competed at home here this season. They bested Utah State here at the America First Event Center a year ago, and they haven't lost in just about two calendar years at home. And you can see why, as the crowd has continued to fill the bowl here in Cedar City. They've got such great support. And for a visiting team, it's a little bit different in gymnastics than, say, a basketball or a football, where the crowd is openly hostile. But still, the momentum always feels like it flows with the home team.
Exactly. I think for them, they're trying to, I mean, they don't have a home crowd here to cheer them on. So it's just them. It's just their teammates. Maybe a few people come from out of town to watch. But, I mean, it's so overwhelming to be in your own stadium and feed off of that energy that the crowd is giving. You know, just like you said, in basketball, it's so back and forth. It's so, you don't know who you're sitting next to. It could be an enemy of the other team. But, you know, here it's just positive energy, but it's all dominating typically on one side. You're just not really getting that other side of the other team with a lot of support. However, at Best of Utah, that I feel like there was a great mix of all, so you could really feel the crowd cheering for everyone, and you were able to feed off of that. But it is a little bit different, I think, going forward with teams when you're traveling. One of my favorite mounts right here on beam. Such a unique mount, so beautiful. Shai is so experienced on beam. She just has the confidence up there. You want to make this look effortless, and she certainly does. Finishing that full turn on high toe, that skill, it can be the most frustrating skill because it's so simple, and yet it can cause a lot of grief, and she just executed that beautifully. A slight wobble there. She hung on to that series, though. Handspring layout, step out. A little bit of a balance check there as well on that side aerial. Again, though, just getting right back into it, trying not to miss a beat. That is called a sheep jump, where your both legs come up to hit the back of your head. You're looking for your hips to be open and in line. Hip height. She's finishing up with cartwheel. Gainer full. It's always kind of hard when you're confident in your skills, but something kind of throws you off. You get that little like, oh, and then it can make you a little bit nervous. She seemed to hang on to all of her skills today. That was a great finish for her.
And on the balance beam, it has arguably the smallest margin for error.
Yes, it does. In fact, it's all about just staying on that beam and doing it well, executing that well. It's 4 inches wide. It's pretty small. Some people's foot is wider than that, so.
Marley Peterson has our first floor routine of the night. One of three freshmen for head coach Kristen White in her first season.
This is such a fun apparatus to watch because they really get to express their personality. Front layout, Rudy, or front one and a half twist. Great combination. They're always required to have a leap pass of some kind, showing off their flexibility and their ability to jump, their amplitude. They can have two passes if their difficulty is high enough. Typically, most have three. Great double tuck. We're looking for that chest to come up, that controlled landing, and she showed both of those things. A lot of energy in that pass. So two passes right there, as we talked about. She had that difficulty for that lay Rudy. And then to end with a double tuck, which I believe gets them at another bonus. They get a 10th bonus to end their, if they end their routine with a double flip. And so you were able to see that there. A good start for Utah State on floor.
And when gymnasts are formulating their routines, as Rachel Smith steps up to the balance beam, what goes into determining whether she wants to have two or three passes?
Usually that's the coach's call, right? If they can get the difficulty in there with those floor passes, then it's like, well, why not do two? Because it's just less deduction. The longer they're on the floor, the more deduction they have typically, or they can have. So if you can get everything done and in two passes, you might as well do it. Rachel Smith on beam is probably one of my favorites to watch just because of her series. It's such a unique series. Round off, layout, step out. I would argue to say that it's probably one of the more difficult ones. A great beamer. She knows how to bring it. She's a great round off one and a half dismount. You can just see her rise on that. And that's what they're looking for, that stuck landing, but rising off of the beam that's punching all the way through her toes, her legs. And she does such a great job with that. Obviously, she does that same scale, round off, layout, step out in her series, which is why she can do it so successfully.
And this is Brianna Brooks up on floor now for the Aggies.
Floor is such a fun apparatus to watch because everybody gets to show off what they're really great at. You know, for her, you can tell already she's very flexible and she's got a fun personality. You can tell by their floor music. So I love watching floor. Starting us off, front layout, front double twist, huge pass. A lot of difficulty right there. You see a hand go up. That means she did step out of bounds, which is a 10th off. You have to have people standing around the floor in the corners because the judges can't see if they've stepped out. That's what they're looking for. You're always looking for front and back passes, so they are required to have passes that move, tumbling passes that move forward and or backwards. So for her, she went front layout, front double twist, but she did just do a back handspring layout step out, which does fulfill the requirement for going backwards, so this pass will most likely go forward. And it does front layout to front full. A little bit of form break there on that front layout. We're looking for her to rise up on that. She just kicked a little early and had to bend those knees. Great finish for her. Again, another two-pass routine, fulfilling those requirements.
Utah State off to their strongest start of the night here in rotation number three, a 9-8, a career best for the freshman Marley Peterson on her floor routine. Rachel Smith also has a 9-8 that is now being followed by the junior from New York, Haley Voltaggio.
Haley's got great confidence on beam. I love watching her perform. She just makes her skills look effortless. Great form. A triple series. Oh, that's unfortunate. Again, we're looking for difficulty in our skills, so adding that handspring, layout, those three skills connected, that's a tricky combination. Just that full turn. I think it says a lot about them as well when they do experience an error like that, to get back up and be confident, not let that rattle you, not give away any other deductions. Standing round off 1.5, she's so quick. A good finish for her.
Angel Stewart, who has competed once tonight, her vault notched a 9.65 in the previous rotation, and now she steps up for her floor routine.
You can see they have two mats on the floor. You're allowed to have only two mats on floor. Any more than that would be a deduction. And then they have to keep the tape lines on there, so you have to reset those tape lines every time, making sure that the floor stays even and that you can track if they go out of bounds. They know where to start and finish their floor routine.
And there you can see the first two beam scores for Southern Utah, 9.7 from Shai Murakami. Could have been much worse. She very nearly fell off. Haley Voltaggio unfortunately did, so that score likely to be dropped with still three to go. Rachel Smith leading the way with a 9.8.
That's a great score for Rachel. Solid beam routine.
Had a 9.75 last week at the Best of Utah and finishes just 0.025 off her season high of 9.825.
This is Rachel's fifth year, right?
That is correct.
Yeah, that's amazing. Looks like they flashed that score, 9.375 on floor. Again, they're looking for that amplitude. Good form when you're on floor, great presentation. I mean, if you can name it, they can deduct for it. So the fact that these girls are averaging 9.8s and 9.7s speaks well of their preparation.
So off goes Angel Stewart after a little bit of a wait.
Double pike to open again with that chest up. Great start. Round off whip half front full. That is a quick tumbling pass. You have to be quick on your toes, know how to punch. She executed that very nicely. Looks like this will be a three-pass routine, which takes a lot more endurance. Trying to pull out another pass, especially toward the end. Your floor routine can only be a minute 30 long. Oh, a little short on that double. She pulled that out though, held on to it, was able to save it. But gets that 10th bonus for finishing her floor routine with a double back.
Ellie Cachola is up next on the beam for Southern Utah, who set a career best mark, 9.85 with her vault. She was second in that lineup, and she is fourth here in this third rotation for Coach Bauman and the Thunderbirds.
I'm always curious how they decide. What is their strategy? How do they move that around?
And there's a push and pull component of it, too. Do you want to put someone who you feel most confident about up at the top,
yes,
or to anchor it at the back in case you have a fall in there. I mean,
right. And do they move that around? I mean, once it's set, it sounds like it's set. Is that right?
Well, it can move around pretty late in the process for the most part.
She is killing it up there, looking so strong and confident, bamming every single skill.
And she, like Rachel Smith, doing just about everything with a big smile on her face.
Yes, and that leap combination is very tricky. Switch leap to split jump. Three combos in a row, three skills in a row, and it's hard to do those. Beautiful routine. That was a beautiful routine. Honestly, I don't even know if there was a deduction there. Not that I could see. Stuck routine. I have to agree with the crowd there. That's a pretty solid routine. She hit every skill, not a wobble, completely leg straight, pointed toes. I mean, what a beam routine. I'd love to see a 10.
I think the fans would love to see a 10 even more.
If it's not, I got to look at those judges' notes and see where they're taking it off.
Olivia Ostendorf up next on floor. Strong showing last week at the Best of Utah with a 9.85.
See how she opens this pass. Front layout to front 1.5 twist or Rudy, and a great start. Nice clean landing. A wolf full to switch side leap. Straddle jump. Some fun floor choreography down there. Two pass as well. Around that back hamstring, double back. A little short on those arms. You want to see those arms extend all the way up by their ears before they initiate that flip. Without it, you have a harder time rotating and can result in a shorter landing. But a nice floor routine.
So Aubrey Schwartz, who fell off the uneven parallel bars earlier, will now give it a go on the balance beam.
Did that score flash? Oh, it did. Oh.
It's a 9.925 for Ellie Cachola.
I still think it should have been at 10.
That is a career high for her on the beam. So two separate events where the sophomore has set career marks, having one heck of a night. And Aubrey Schwartz off to a strong start here in her beam routine.
She's looking very clean right now, and I think that says a lot about her coming back from a fall on an event. Again, my experience with club definitely shows. That was great right there. But it definitely shows that's something that we're trying to teach. When these girls make a mistake, to come back, you know, brush it off, go to your next event and hit it. And it looks like she's doing just that. Beautiful leaps, that beach jump layout step out, and a finish standing full stuck dismount. She comes back with a bang. That's exactly how it should be done. You make a mistake, you brush it off, you come back and do what you know how to do. That's signs of a strong mindset. She's in the right place and had good team support.
2-me up next on the floor for Utah State, Ariel 2-me. First time she's competed here tonight. Matched a career high on floor a week ago to begin the season, and we'll look to try and build on that here.
She opens up this pass. That is a front 1.5 twist with a back layout step out, which they are allowed to step out of. Now in college, we're always looking for that stick. On floor, you are allowed to step back as long as that shows controlled landing. Everything else should be stuck with 2 feet, except for floor, you are allowed that one step. If it doesn't show control, if that front foot moves, that's where deduction comes in. Coming up on this next pass. Front full, front full. Great combo. I believe that's CC connection. So we're ending that with a nice strong finish. 2 floor passes.
Already a couple scores at an even 9-8 from Ostendorf and Peterson for Utah State.
I love watching Carly on beam. She just attacks that beam.
She's also the sort of gymnast who attacks everything she does.
That's very well
in
said.
In the best way possible. It's an even 9-9 for Aubrey Schwartz in front of her. So back-to-back scores, 9-9 and above for Southern Utah.
It's so impressive watching Carly. She just knows that beam. She's up there with all the confidence, just oozing from her fingertips. She just gets up. Gets the job done. Going into that combination, cat leap side aerial, I have to say, I'm so impressed right now. These girls are looking so strong. Split jump straddle quarter again, nice clean landings, absorbing that beam. Comes that full turn, high releve on toe. I always hold my breath because it's that skill that's worth nothing, but it can just be the death of you. Here's her nice finish. Round off, 1.5. Stuck landing. Come on. That was 3 great beam routines back to back for SUU. Incredible. What a way to finish the lineup for Carly. That was awesome.
Thunderbirds look like they will be notching 4 scores at 9-8 or higher, and McLean will, you would think, be in that 9-9 range. But our final performer here in rotation, number 3, Amari Evans out of McKinney, Texas. Had an excellent floor last week at the Best of Utah, 9.85. And here she goes for round 2.
You can already tell a fun personality starting this off. Strong run. Front leg. Rudy. They've got some great front twisters here. The difficulty is high again because it is those blind landings you cannot see, which makes it hard to stick. A switch ring to torsion to half. Weight combo, also very difficult. Definitely can't see it. That means no backhand spring. There are many reasons why coaches take that out. And a great finish for her. Again, getting that 10th bonus for ending with the double tuck. It looks like their head coach is really trying to be strategic about those 2 passes. You know, we talked about where they add bonus. The floor routine, their scores always start at a 9-4, and they have to build back with bonus by connections or difficulty and skill. So if you're cramming all of that into those 2 passes, that's going to be how clean can you execute those passes? How can you get those scores to their maximum value? And that's going to be, you know, getting them on the floor and off the floor as quick as possible and as clean as possible. So it looks like that's kind of the strategy she's going for. The girls are doing great coming out of their first season, at the beginning of the season, their second meet. It was a good recovery after a rocky start. And to be able to finish floor and not really have any crazy things happening.
One step out of bounds, but overall looks like it'll be a strong third rotation. Scotty Bauman and Kristen White now get their teams ready for the fourth and final rotation, which we'll bring you right after this.
That's awesome. It's a huge score. So Jamie used to be their beam coach. Jeff was their vault and floor. And then Scott was bars and they...
Sorry, everybody, about that. Welcome back. Spencer McLaughlin, Kimmy Hermanson with you after a mighty impressive third rotation from Southern Utah. They set a season high on the balance beam, and as we were just discussing, there's been a little bit of shuffling on the coaching front for Southern Utah on that apparatus.
There has been. It's been really interesting to watch. But Scott, who is infamous for not ever watching beam, has been taking over coaching on beam, and obviously whatever he's doing is working. A 49-2 is a huge score. They looked so solid up there, even with a fall, to not being able to count that, for those girls to come back and hit three routines so solidly after that, big high scores for them. It's pretty fun to watch. I'm really impressed. I don't know what he's doing, but it's obviously working.
They were mighty impressive indeed. They started with a 9-7 from Shai Murakami, which is certainly not up to standard that she has set, which is a testament to how talented of a gymnast she really is. And then Voltaggio falls in the third slot in the rotation. And then Cachola, Schwartz, and McLean go 9-9-2-5, 9-9, and 9-8-7-5. That has to make a coach smile about his lineup choices.
I mean, I'm smiling, and I'm not in charge of that event, so it's pretty exciting. Beam is always a nerve-wracking event to watch. You know, it's all trying to stay on, and then not just stay on, but do it well, execute it well, eliminating those balance checks. On things like floor, you can get away with it, right? Your adrenaline's pumping, you're ready to go, and you can get rid of that energy by performing big. But on beam, it's like people have a tendency to pull back instead of attack, and those girls, they attacked tonight. It was so great to watch.
One of the girls who attacked exceptionally well, Ellie Cachola, who has set two career marks here tonight on vault and on the balance beam as well. The sophomore having quite the go of it this evening.
Oh, I really felt like it should have been a 10, but again, I'm not down there. So she started off great. She looked so clean. We're watching this right now. Again, just flawless. Everything is hit so strong. She just looks confident, graceful up there. You can see this series, she just comes up, nothing, no wobble, no movement. Just moving seamlessly from one skill to the next. This nice combination of beat, jump, layout, step out, huge smile, she knows she has it. A lot of times when a routine is so perfect, it's almost easier to be more critical, if that makes sense. You know, when it's so clean, you can almost like nitpick every little thing. But honestly, I just don't know where they see it, because my goodness, look at that. Stuck landing, such great amplitude on the dismount. Really impressive.
And she was not the only beam performer who was impressive. Aubrey Schwartz, who fell on bars earlier, responded in a big way for the Thunderbirds.
Oh, we talked about that a little bit, but being able to come back after falling on an event, I think speaks volumes of where they are mentally. You can tell her experience is being able to brush off whatever happened on one event and come back and nail an event, especially an event like beam, where it can get in your head. And she showed none of that. She was solid. Right here you see this flick lay, nice and clean. She comes up, no wobble. Just a strong finish for everything. Nice full turn. I love their new Leos this year.
Now they're debuting those tonight.
Oh, yeah, looks great. Another same combination, beat jump, layout, step out into beat jump. A lot of times if you feel like you missed that connection, those girls have to kind of think on the fly, like, oh, did I make that? I might need to add something in.
That was a solid finish as well.
Step landing, great. Gainerful dismount.
Utah State with their strongest rotation of the evening at 48.875, and they got a really strong floor routine from Maya Peterson, or Marley Peterson, beg your pardon, and we are going to now go right into rotation number 4 And it is Jenna Eagles, the junior, at a 9.75 in her beam last week. And we'll give it a go here in meet number two for the Aggies, getting some words of encouragement before she starts off this final rotation of the night.
You know, I have to give them credit, really, you know, with this rocky start. It's always hard to come back and keep your morale up. To see them finish the way they did on floor, I think speaks a lot about their head coach pulling the team together, the culture they've created. You can see right now the strong start. Nice full turn, get that turn out of the way. Right into her series, back handspring, layout, step out. Oh, it's really hard to save that landing when your chest drops with straight legs. She did try to bend there at the last minute, but you really want to try and get your center of gravity back over, and it's hard when that happens. Side aerial to split jump, great combination there. Moving into leaps, trying to get that 180 split. Those two connections have bonus. Getting ready to dismount, round off, 1.5 step landing. It's always great to have a strong finish when you have a fall on beam. And hopefully their next step will be able to pick up the momentum and have a good hit routine.
Third event of the night for Haley Voltaggio, and she starts off the one that all the fans really come to see, especially the students, the home team on floor.
Right. She's such a fun dancer. A lot of attitude. Going into her first pass, round of handspring, double pike. Again, looking at that nice landing, that chest up, big double pike. Beautiful leap combination. Really showing off her flexibility. So this is unique. She's going 1.5 front layout down the floor instead of the diagonal. Not something you see very often. Getting that crowd excited and involved.
They show up in big numbers from the moment the meet starts, but if they could only come for one, this would be the rotation.
We've said it. Getting ready for this pass. Round up handspring, double tuck. The crowd goes wild. Great finish for Haley. Very nice routine.
She scored 9.8 or above in all three of her floor routines so far in this 2023 season, and another strong start there for Haley Voltaggio. Lexi Aragon up now on the balance beam for the Aggies.
I think this is where they're really going to be able to see how they move lineups around. This is where the strategy comes into play. Who's coming up strong as a first starter? Who's making, you know, some of those mistakes where we might have to move things around in the lineup? Looking at every single thing they do, every step should be with their toe first. You know, making sure they're hitting that full split at 180 degrees. Just things you don't really know. Most of the time we're looking for, did they wobble or not? But even within the skill, to make sure that they're executing that strongly. Going into her series now, back handspring layout, step out. Didn't quite pull up to finish.
And when a gymnast is on the balance being unable to stay on like that, what as a coach do you try and tell her technically to try and improve upon? What's the most common thing that'll get her off balance?
You know, a lot of times, even if you're crooked, you can figure out a way to save that. But I think what I noticed with her is just not finishing that skill all the way through, not pulling up with those arms and watching the end of the beam. You know, if you're unsure of where you're landing, if you look down, what I always say, you go down. So if you're looking down when your feet finish, then you're most likely going to have a hard time saving that. And she did finish strong, that front semi, that D skill that's hard. It's hard landing. She did it really well. And her dismount. You know, again, I have to give props to these girls who are making these errors and falling, but are getting up and finishing their routine strong. You can tell it's all there. It's just a matter of their time, putting it together. You know, by end of season, I'm sure all of those kinks will be worked out.
Well, Ellie Cachola doesn't need any time to get in a rhythm. She has been in the zone tonight and competes for the third time.
And you can see it. And the personality in this is so great. She smiles through everything. Look at that controlled landing. That's what we've been talking about, the chest up, stepping back, showing that she knows exactly where she is. I love the choreography. Jamie does such a great job matching choreography for every girl out there. I love the crowd interaction. Front full, front layout. Again, nice and controlled landing. Huge smile for her. The switch ring to switch half. Hard combination to do. Definitely a slower routine, but not lacking in any energy at all. She just performs every move with all of her energy. Finishing up with a Rudy to split jump. What a great finish.
What a night for the sophomore.
This team camaraderie, the support after every routine, whether it was amazing or whether they had a mistake, they're there supporting, high-fiving. I think that says a lot for what they've created at SUU.
This is Olivia Ostendorf, her third event of the night.
Again, watching those arms pulling up. Now she spotted the end of that beam, was able to save it. And there's a lot of pressure on her right now to make sure she can finish this routine nice and strong. Split jump, tuck full, something you don't see very often, but a fun, unique combination. Going into D scale, that's called a front semi or a row. Has a lot of names, actually. Looking strong right here to finish. Round up 1.5. Little hop on the landing, but she had a pretty solid events for her today as an all-arounder. And that's what you want. You want somebody that you know you can rely on, who's going to come and bring their game every time. She had a good, strong finish to her competition today.
And Ostendorf, the senior, someone a coach like can rely on to put in the lineup and know what to expect. And Coach Bauman knows what to expect from Rachel Smith, one of the highest energy performers the Thunderbirds have.
One of my favorite passes you don't see often, round off whip, double tuck, beautifully done. And that whip, different than a back handspring, where it's basically a back handspring with no hands. Just a little different. Great leap combo for her. Tourjete split full into Shushanova. Again with the crowd interaction. I just love it. It gives them all of that energy, hypes them up, especially to finish. Now Rachel is a two passer. Rudy to split jump. Split jump. Fun routine for Rachel Smith. She nailed those passes. Leaps looking awesome. Such strong motion, energy from her, which we always want to see him performing on floor.
And Smith has a pair of strong scores in front of her. Haley Voltaggio matches her season high with a 9.875. And Ellie Cachola, a 9.85, which ties her career high on the floor exercise. set two personal bests and match it in another event. Pretty good night for Ellie Cacciola.
I would say. I mean, she's on a roll. Great mount over here on Utah State. Very difficult to do. Shows off flexibility. And I have to say, as you get older, it is hard to maintain that. So to watch that is really impressive.
This is Brianna Brooks up again for the Aggies and first-year head coach Kristen White.
What a gorgeous combination right there. That's front aerial to Corbett, which is a back handspring roll all the way down. Then she went right into a backward roll and did this really awesome chest turn thing. I don't even know what it is. Honestly, I don't even know if that has a name, but that was really unique. Beautiful to watch. I love when you can see the artistry here in beam. It's not something you see a lot of because it can be risky when you're doing different skills. So when you see somebody do it, you know they've been doing it for a long time. They're consistent with it. It's always fun to watch in the college world of gymnastics. Again, really nice flick, full twisting gator pull.
Rachel Smith, a 9.925 on the floor exercise, and she matches her career high as well, as did Ellie Cacciola. Thunderbirds looking strong at home once again, and now they send out arguably their best gymnast, Carly McLean, for the fourth straight meet, competing in the all-around.
Carly, just like on every event that we've talked about, just attacks this apparatus. Round up, handspring, full in, and sticks the landing. That is a full twisting double back. Very difficult skill, and she just did that effortlessly. Moving into this second pass, round up, front layout, so controlled. I mean, she just looks like she walks into that thing. It is done so well. Moving along into lead pass, switch half, willful. Can't help but smile watching Carly. You can tell she's just having so much fun out there. Love how her teammates move right along with her as she gets ready for this third and final pass, which I believe is a double tuck, giving her that bonus. 10. Round up back handspring, double tuck, huge double tuck. What a way to finish for Carly. All four events once again. The endurance you have to have, the mental capacity she has to just bring it time and time again, speaks volumes of her experience, her confidence, and her ability, and the coaches that have the confidence in her to be able to bring it every time. Just incredible.
And McLean last week at the Best of Utah, a 39.475 in the all-around, one of the five best scores in Southern Utah history. She went into that last rotation at a 29.55, and we'll see what the judges award her as we get our first and only look of the night at Sophie Sullivan. The senior from Manhattan Beach, California, has been one of the most productive and consistent gymnasts for Utah State over the last couple of seasons.
You said it, Spencer. I can already tell just watching her. She has attacked everything about this beam routine. A slight step on that dismount, but otherwise very clean. She hit those skills beautifully, and I think that you said it. It speaks of her consistency over the years, her experience. That was a great routine.
She's the reigning co-MRGC beam specialist of the week after notching a 9.9 to begin the season last year. So Southern Utah looking dominant in the floor exercise. Turn again to the junior, Aubrey Schwartz, competing in everything except vault here this evening. And has one of the highest scores of the night as well at a 9.9 on beam.
Front handspring, front double full. Very difficult. difficult first pass. Again with those blind landings. That E value we were talking about, difficulty. So fun. Jamie always has nice surprises on floor, fun to watch. Switch leap into Tourjeté half wolf pole. Nice leap combination right there.
Jamie Weissong handles the choreography for the girls' floor routines. An assistant coach since 2016.
Again, getting that crowd to get in and interact. That's just something you can't have at an away meet. There she goes, right hand spring. Rudy to back layout step out, and that's where we talked about. Pass is having to go forward and backwards, so that backwards skill is that layout. Again, being able to cram in all of that deduction, all of the deduction, what am I saying? All that bonus and difficulty into two passes. She's looking great.
They've announced a 9.925 for Carly McLean on her floor routine. So Southern Utah perhaps ending on their strongest note of the night here on the floor with back-to-back 9.925s. The last performer of the evening for the Aggies, Danny Kirstein. Off to a good start here on her balance beam routine.
She's looking really great, attacking these skills. That is a cat leap to side semi. Beautiful. Chest is up. Nice and clean as she executes her leaps, just hitting everything. You can see the confidence in her as she performs up there. She knows how to do these skills. Oh, that's unique. Standing front full off of one leg. It's a gainer because, again, off the one leg. Not a dismount you see very often, but she did that very well.
Our final gymnast of the night, Taylor Goh. The sophomore, a 9.8 a week ago, set a career high. And here she goes in front of the home fans. Southern Utah looking like they will comfortably walk away with a victory here tonight, but always looking to get better. Southern Utah saved their strongest rotations for last. Season highs on beam and floor, and it looks like they will set a season high mark in the all-around as well. We'll have the final scores tally it all up. Well, rather, other people will tally it up for us, and we'll just tell you what happens. And we'll recap everything that we've seen so far. Back in Cedar City after this. One of the 50 best floor exercise gymnasts in the country coming into tonight's meet. Notches a 9.925, one of two Thunderbirds to get that score, and she looked completely in control.
She did an incredible job, as you can see right here. She just walks into that thing and just knows how to land it. She's got so much power. She just makes it look effortless. She did that nice pull in to open the floor and just stuck the landing, and then finished again with a really nice double tuck. I mean, again, just a strong floor worker, so consistent, something they can always rely on. I mean, she just looks like she's having so much fun out there.
Back-to-back weeks with a 9.925 with her floor routine.
On uneven parallel bars, in third place with a 9.85 from Southern Utah, Carly McLean.
McLean, the only
scoring 9.875 in second place from Utah State, Brianna Brooks.
39.475.
And your winner of the uneven parallel bars with a 9.925 from SUU, Shailin Murakami. On the balance beam, in third place, scoring a 9.875 from SUU, Carly McLean. In second place with a 9.9 from Southern Utah, Aubrey Schwartz.
So impressed with Aubrey.
And the winner on the balance beam with a 9.925 from SUU, Ellie Cachola.
What a night for Ellie.
Ellie Cachola had one heck of a night.
And on the floor exercise, in third place with a 9.875. From SUU, Haley Voltaggio. And in a tie for first place, both scoring 9.925, both Thunderbirds, Rachel Smith and Carly McLean.
Scores in an event, they award that hammer and raise the hammer, to speak.
Well, that's a fun one.
And the winner of the all-around on the evening, first of all, in second place for Utah State with a 38.8, Brianna Brooks.
38.8 for Brooks competing in the...
And your winner with a 39.475 from SUU, Carly McLean.
How exciting for Carly to be able to go out like that, two meets back to back.
Your final team scores, Utah State with a 193.425, and your SUU Thunderbirds with a 196.6.
It's a big score for SUU.
Highest of the season for Southern Utah in meet number four, and they remain unbeaten here at home since 2021. 196.6 to 193.425. The Thunderbirds even the all-time series. This was number 112 in terms of when they have met on the gymnastics floor, and it's now deadlocked at 56 apiece. These programs, of course, intimately familiar with one another. This the MRGC opener here in this 2023 gymnastics season. We'll step aside, recap what we have seen, and see if we can track down SU head coach Scotty Bauman.
Fans, as a reminder, please.
So see if humanity pleased with what they saw from the Thunderbirds once again. Back in a moment. Spencer McLaughlin, Kimmy Hermanson alongside me here this evening from Cedar City, where Southern Utah prevails with their best score of the season. They came into this meet 21st in the country on the road to nationals, and they put up a 196.6. That is an excellent score, and we're still in the month of January.
It's such a strong start for SUU. Scotty has got to be excited about this home win for them, especially against Utah State with all their history. It's just been an exciting night. Such a strong start and an even stronger finish for SUU.
And for Utah State, they got off to a rocky start with a couple of falls on the uneven bars. They wind up with a 47.825, but to the Aggies' credit, with a first-year head coach, they really responded well as the meet went on.
You're bound to see mistakes like that, and as we've talked about, those jitters kind of in the beginning. This is only their second meet of the season. To be able to come in like that, have that rocky start like we talked about, but then to finish up the way that they did speaks a lot about their head coach, what she's doing with them, and how they're responding to their to her coaching.
Let's take a look now at what is upcoming for each of these teams as they progress through this 2023 season, starting with Utah State. This is just their second meet of the year. They began at the Best of Utah, and they're at SUU tonight, and then they will have their first home meet of the year a week from today against BYU in an MRGC dual meet showdown. And I have to imagine the Aggies' first two meets away from home, it'll feel good to finally be in front of their home fans.
Absolutely. As we talked about that, there's nothing quite like that home crowd that brings you the energy that you need, that you can feed off of, and they're going to want that after having kind of a rough start on the open road today. Although Best of Utah, they were really strong. They did a great job opening up the season, so it'll be good for them to be back home.
195.8 last week, 193.425 here tonight, and they'll look to build on that with a string of dual meets going forward, and then a tri-meet and a quad meet before the MRGC Championships, which will be right here at the America First Event Center in Cedar City. For Southern Utah, meanwhile, they have still been outscored in any form of meet this year by just one team, and that was the Utes of Utah, a top five program in the country right now. They will have another MRGC meet next week as they go at Boise State. And then they will be back at home against BYU. And then they will play BYU again and continue through. It is a busy, populated schedule for Southern Utah this season. And I'm excited to now be joined here on the post-meet wrap-up by Jamie Weissong, an assistant coach for Southern Utah. Her team victorious tonight, 196.6 to 193.425. And, coach, just your assessment of how your team performed tonight.
They were scrappy. That's what we'll call it. You know, they didn't make it easy on themselves. Warm-ups were a little off, but it was really great to see them come out and just fire in them, keep fighting, and they continue to get better and better each meet. And we're still making mistakes, so that shows us we have a lot of room for improvement.
You've continued to improve week after week through the four meets this season. First down in Vegas, then against New Hampshire, then the Best of Utah, now here at home, just continuing to build forward. What does that say about the progress your team is making?
We're on track. That's the goal. You know, we don't out of the gate. We got to make sure that we're slowly making our adjustments. Our landings are starting to come together, but they're building confidence. And the more confidence they build, the more of the actual gymnastics we're going to start seeing.
You put up a season high as a team to this point in the year on the balance beam and on the floor exercise as well. What was it about those routines that were just clicking tonight?
You know, I mean, we were still making a lot of mistakes, but they were staying calm under that pressure. They weren't allowing those mistakes to ruffle them too much. You know, Ellie Control went out there and just murdered her beam routine. She looked incredible. The confidence, you can see it on her face, just enjoying being up on that beam. And I feel like each meet, they're starting to just enjoy the process rather than focus on, like, the pressure of the situation. Floor, I feel like Haley Voltaggio, she is just dynamite, little stick of dynamite. And she goes out there and starts us off with an incredible energy routine. She's execution is gorgeous. And she sets a precedence for that team. And they continue to roll through each one after another. So it was great to see that. We're really proud of, you know, those leadoff kids doing their job. Shailin didn't have a normal beam routine today, and we still did a good job on beam. So I'm proud of them. That's good to see.
One of the gymnasts who shone most brightly tonight, arguably, was Ellie Cachola, a career best mark on the balance beam and on the vault to begin in the first rotation. What about you? What about what you've seen from her has allowed her to get to this sort of moment?
Ellie has built confidence inside that gym, and it's showing in the competition arena now. She works so hard. And it's now, she's taking her brain kind of out of it. It's funny because gymnastics is so hard, but you really have to take your brain out of it and just let it go. So she's allowing herself to just do her awesome gymnastics. And you can see that she's enjoying it. So I think that's kind of like a positive reinforcement for her to continue doing that.
Carly McLean continues to score over 39 in the all-around week in and week out. A fifth-year senior who Coach Bauman, and I'm sure yourself as well, had to convince a little bit to come back. But how much of a benefit is it for you as coaches to have someone like that to rely on?
When you have a leader on the floor like Carly, that builds, I mean, you have someone to look up to. And I know that, I mean, they're all the same age, they're all, you know, doing the same things, but when you have someone who has that much experience, I feel like it gives the team confidence knowing she's got my back or I'm trying to reach up to that level. Carly's incredible. She is having so much fun this year. I think having Kennedy here with her, it's just brought out a different side of Carly, and she's an animal. We love it. She is incredible, and she's just enjoying every minute in the gym now.
Lastly, Coach, as you look forward to next week, what do you want to see your team improve upon the most, but also carry over from another successful home meet?
That little by little, taking those little steps. We keep putting ourselves in a little bit of a hole in the middle of our lineups with mistakes. So seeing them just be able to actually maybe hit 6 out of 6 on each event would be really nice. That would definitely help the energy, but our girls do a great job of rebounding back with the energy. So our energy is great. We want to keep that energy, continue to focus on those little things inch by inch, but maybe not give ourselves such a little, you know, hard time in the middle there. Sweat beads dripping sometimes.
Sometimes easier said than done, though. But well done tonight, Coach. We'll let you get back to celebrate with your team. A 196.6, the highest score of the season to date for Southern Utah. Still a long way to go as they pick up an MRGC victory here against Utah State. That'll do it for us here on the broadcast tonight for our entire production crew and my color analyst, who was fantastic, Kimmy Hermanson. I'm Spencer McLaughlin saying so long. This has been a production of ESPN. All games and meets and everything else streaming live on ESPN are available on the ESPN app. We'll see you next time, whenever and wherever that may be. Hope you all have a wonderful rest of your night. Easy money.
Well done. Well-